Hi and welcome to my channel. I'm Ashwini and today I'm going to teach you how to make editable PDFs. So I have an annotation right here which I created using Adobe Illustrator. So if you want me to post a video of how to do this using Illustrator, just leave a comment below and I'll post it as soon as I can. To create an editable PDF, you actually need a tool called Adobe Acrobat Pro. It is not the free version. The free version on a system is usually called Adobe Reader. So this is one of the many other items that you get on Adobe. So what we can do, what is an editable PDF? So you can customize an invitation, like you can put this on Etsy or something to sell, and people who buy your stuff, like your customers, can go in and change these names, etc. Without having an Adobe Acrobat Pro. So how do we do this? So this is my invitation, and obviously I need certain fields that needs to be modified on a regular basis. Not everyone's called Kevin and not everybody is turning one. So what we do is we should make certain fields editable and the rest of the fields stay as it is, like your basic design, the fonts, etc. stay the way they are, but you should let the person make changes to the name, etc. So what are the editable fields right here? It's this one. It could be a he or a she. So obviously this can stay as it is. The designs won't change. Here we just have to change this part and then when and where. So what we're going to do is we need these fields blank before we can take into Acrobat Pro and edit it. So, and we also need to know what is the font size, the font color, etc. before we move to Acrobat Pro. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to delete this part. But before that, I make a note of what it is. It's regular 48 point. So I'm just going to save this as a file. I think I have a file already. So I'm just going to delete this. And I'm going to delete this as well. And this. And this as well. Now we're going to save this as a PDF. How do you do that? You go to Illustrator File. I'm sorry, you cannot see that. Okay, File. And then you go into Save As. You get a pop-up window. And in the drop-down button, it's usually, by default, it's set to Adobe Illustrator. So make sure you change it to Adobe PDF. And then select your folder and you just give it whatever you want to say. So I'm just going to rename this as birthday_1. Oh, okay, and save. So don't worry about this and you can just click save PDF. So what you're going to do next is go ahead and open up your Adobe So you have your Adobe Pro open now. So you just head over to Tools and then you click Prepare Form under Forms and Signatures. You can see that over here as well. So you can just go there, just click on that. Now you have to select the file. So you just click on Select PDF, okay, Open, Start, Ignore. So now you have your general PDF which you took, created in Illustrator right here. So the next step would be to actually put in those fields. So let's go ahead and open up our Illustrator. And I'm going to open up the other file which has all the properties in it. So I'm just going to go ahead and take each part. Like for this one, this is set to Buttercup Sample. It's a sample text. And it's 14 point. And the color is set to, obviously you know all these things because you, if you know how to use the Illustrator, you know. I'm just going to copy the hex code and head over to Adobe Acrobat. Now I'm going to click on this box which says text, add a text field. So I'm going to click on that. You see, you can see a box kind of a thing right here, and it has a nice edges which you can see. So I'm just gonna click and make a box here. Or you can give any name you want. It's not gonna show up. Next, you click on properties and then you go to appearance. It's a little slow. Text color. So you have the hex code. Okay, close it off. Font size was 14. This one was Buckleberry. So sometimes, okay, I think it was Buttercup. This is because it's not supported by PDFs, but that's okay. You can just give it okay. So one more thing that you have to always, always consider when you're trying to sell these cards to people is that you have to give them instructions on how to download these fonts. These fonts are something which are there on your system. They're not going to be there on the person's other customer's system. And when they open up their PDF, they're not going to see this font. They're going to see your randomized font, which closely matches this, but definitely it's not going to be as cool as this. So you should always include instructions on how to download this font. And please note, not all fonts are free. So if you want to sell it commercially, you need to buy a license. So please be sure that what you have is something which others can use as well. So I'm going to change this. We don't want any border color. We don't want any fill color. I'm going to go to options and I'm going to say center because this is really, really important. And then close. So we have text one here. Now, if I go back here, here it says he turns and one in the separate line. So I want that. So I'm just going to hit text. Go right below that. Say this. And then same thing, I'm going to change it to 14. And this goes to Buttercup sample. Okay, I don't want to, the reason I don't click on do not show this message again is because I get to know what fonts are something which I downloaded and what fonts are the ones which were already on the system because I have tons of fonts. So I don't click on that do not show this again message because I like seeing this message, which reminds me that this might not be there on other system. So I go to text color and okay, next is center. I'm gonna hit close. So now we have two things ready right here. I'm gonna hit preview right here. So now this is gonna show like this. And you can type he turns and then one. Okay, you can see the mistake right here. This is overlapping. And obviously that's a different font because I couldn't find my font. So what I'm gonna do is go hit edit again and try to bring this up a little and adjust this a little. And probably this as well. Oh, this needs a lot of space. Okay. Overlap it a bit. Doesn't matter. Okay. Let's see the preview. Yay. That's good, isn't it? So, we have it right there. Now, we need to add a box right here. So, I'm going to go ahead and click on text. This is going to be one single name. So, I'm going to hit... Okay, all properties. So I'm going to go back to my AI and hit on this and see what it says. It's Buttercup regular 48 point. So go here. This is center. This is 48. Okay. This Buttercup. Okay, I need to close this. There you go. Okay. Close. Just gonna hit preview. Oh, I gave the wrong color, didn't I? So I'm just gonna go back and go into my color field. Okay. Right click, properties. That's how you get in if you cannot. Go in. And then hit close. So preview. Okay. So edit. Okay. Wonderful. So this seems right. And now let's click on preview. There you go. You type in anything now. Roberts. So always make sure that you align the text as center. And if you want people to know like where they need to type, you can always leave a message saying that, you know, type here or something. But what happens is since you cannot decrease the font size or something, this is what something might happen. So I'm going to make sure, I'm going to put it as, leave it blank. And this one too, we need to take it off because people need to type in there. Okay. So you do the same thing for when and where. And once you're done, all you do is go to File and Save. And yeah, obviously you can see these files. I'm just going to hit Save now so that I can show it to you. So this is going to be, I'm not going to do reduce font size or restrict editing because I want it to be just the way it is. So I'm going to say editable and hit save. So let's close this off. So I'm going to open this with Adobe Reader to say this is what most of the people have, default program. So like I said, you don't need a pro to edit it. So once I open it, okay, no, I don't want it. So this is how you see on your invitation. You can always click on this. If you click on this, it comes like this. So I say Kevin's, and then I go here, he turns, I say 2. Oh, Kevin's 2 already. So after this, I can just click save, that is file, save, and then I say file, print. And when I do that, you cannot see those white marks right there, the highlighted ones. It's just to say that, okay, it's an editable field. So you can say that and you can just print it like the way you want. So yes, that is how you make editable PDFs.